So in section four, what we're doing is we're simplifying rational expressions that are either being multiplied or divided. We'll do some division ones down there. You have to be able to factor to do this. So factoring is really important. There's gonna be tons of different kinds of factoring. Sometimes we're just gonna be factoring out a greatest common factor. Sometimes we're gonna be factoring a trinomial. And depending on what that trinomial is, it could be like easier or harder. So we're gonna start off with A, and we have trinomial over trinomial. So we can just factor those like normal. That's like super standard, isn't it? That's not any better. All right, so x squared plus 7x plus 10, we're going to factor that. Two numbers that multiply to 10 and add to 7 are 5 and 2. And then x squared minus 3x minus 10. Two numbers that multiply to negative 10 and add to negative 3, that would be negative 5 and positive 2. Yeah? And then we're going to multiply this by another fraction. We want to factor these as well. So these are binomials, so they can be factored in one of two ways. It's either going to be a difference of squares, or you'll just be able to take out a greatest common factor. So here, I can take out a 3x, and that gives me x minus 5. Here, this is a difference of squares. So you're looking at two numbers that multiply to negative 25 and add to 0. So multiply to negative 25 and add to nothing. That means they have to be the same number, but have different signs. So that would be positive 5 and negative 5. So step one is to factor. Step two, if it's multiplication, then you can basically start simplifying. In order for us to simplify, we can cancel either vertically or diagonally. Not horizontally, because that's the direction you multiply in. We can cancel vertically, because that's basically division. And we can cancel diagonally because that's basically a combination of vertical and horizontal. So it's like essentially still vertical. You don't want to cancel anything that's not a factor. Okay, so if we didn't factor it, you don't want to cancel it. So look real quick, we don't want to do this. Ever. Never do that. Not a thing. Don't do it. Okay, so we don't want to do that. We want to wait till after we've factored. And they have to be the exact same factor, and you can only do one and one. So if there's like 7x plus 5s, you don't get to cancel all of them. They have to be canceled in pairs. So vertically, if I want to cancel vertically, I could cancel the x plus 2s. Yeah? And then diagonally, I could cancel maybe these x plus 5s. And then I have an option to either cancel these x minus 5s diagonally, or these x minus 5s vertically. You can't do both. It doesn't matter which one you do. I'm going to choose to do these two. Okay? Then whatever's left is your answer. So on top, I have a 3x. On the bottom, I have an x minus 5. And that's simple. Nothing else I can do. Now, sometimes they ask you to state restrictions. So I'm probably not going to ask you to do this, but it's helpful to understand the concept for when we do section, I think it's 6, and then it's also kind of ties back into asymptotes. A restriction is something that it's kind of like a hole or an asymptote. Graphically, but it's just an expression, so it's not representing a whole or an asymptote, but it happens when we divide by zero. So even though you were able to cancel this, this, and this out of the denominator, those values still existed in the original question. And then we also have an x minus 5 here in our denominator. Any values that would have created a zero in your denominator are like restrictions. So 5 would give us a 0 in the denominator here. Negative 2 would have given it to us here, and negative 5 would have given us a denominator of 0 there. Those are like restrictions, things that would create like division by 0. So that is something, like I said, I'm not gonna probably ask you for that. You might see it on Math Excel or something. It sort of ties into asymptotes and wholes, and it kind of plays into section 6 where we're gonna be solving equations, and you might get like extraneous solutions. So it's good to know what is like bad. But basically you're just looking at the denominators for that, because that's, you know, the only thing that's bad is when we divide by 0. We can multiply by 0 all day, just not divide.
The steps on the video. Okay.
All right. So try the U try. So for the U try, you know, factor the trinomials normally. The binomials, you're either taking out a greatest common factor or you're going to factor a difference of squares. Okay. So step one, factor. Step two, not quite there yet. So step 1.5. We're going to keep, change, flip, KFC,
chicken,
because it's division. So we're going to keep the first, and we're going to change division to multiplication, and then we're going to flip the second fraction upside down. Because that's what division means. It means to multiply by the reciprocal. So we have to do that before we cancel. So you only have to do that for division. So for division only. All right, now I can cancel diagonally this x plus 1, this x plus 1. I can cancel diagonally this x minus 2, this x minus 2. And I think that's it. Yeah? Do you see anything else? No. So that's it. So I'm now gonna stick everything else together. I have a negative sign, which is like a negative 1. I have x minus 1 on the top. I have an x plus 2 and an x plus 5 on the bottom. And I would like you to multiply these together. Like FOIL them out, do whatever you need to do. For this one, you can kind of apply this same logic over here, like again. So you would change this to 1 minus x and flip it back. And then down here, you just FOIL that out. And that's that. If they want you to state restrictions, I don't think they usually ask for them for division, but if they do, you look here. So a negative 1, a negative 5, and a 2. Yeah?
We keep the change it, flip it. So mm-hmm. You would keep the first, like.
Yeah, keep the, well, so I factored first, but.
Well, yeah.
I guess you could do that in a different order if you want. I just like to factor first.
Yeah,
you could keep change flip first and then factor. But you keep the first fraction,
mm-hmm.
and then you change this multiplication,
mm-hmm.
and then you flip this upside down completely.
Okay.
Yeah. But I suppose you could do that first. There could be like a step 0 if you want to, instead of a 1.5, because that's kind of awkward. Yeah?
Question. Yeah, so look at the this, like the second row, I guess. For the restriction, wouldn't you add like, yeah.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you add 1 as well? Because like, if you think about it.
Positive
like,
1?
Yeah, like 1 minus 1 equals 0. And I'm not sure if that.
But since division really is like multiplying by the reciprocal, we look at it after the multiplication part happens, because it's not really a problem if x is 1, because we would have divided by it, and it would have flipped, and it would have been fine.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. So no, that's why I look at it here, in the multiplication step, usually. Yeah?
Why x could not equals 2?
two. Here, right here, this guy.
Yeah.
From the multiplication step. Right here. Doesn't matter. It's still here in the denominator, even in the final answer. Doesn't have to be what you canceled. It just has to be in the denominator, period. So think about it as like, when you graphed them, you know, if you canceled it, it was a whole. But if you didn't cancel it, it was an asymptote, right? So either way, it was bad. Same thing here. If you cancel it, it's still bad because it was there to begin with. And if you don't cancel it, it's more bad because it's there at the beginning and the end. Yeah, all of them from the denominator of the multiplication step. Yeah. Okay. And this will, the restriction part will kind of make more sense when we start solving equations. When you solve an equation, you'll get something like x equals negative 1. You'll plug it back into the original equation and it won't work. And so that's really the point of us kind of stating them now, is because later on when we solve equations, that is going to be like an extraneous solution. So that's why we're talking about it now. Just mostly, it's mostly for later. Right now it's kind of just, you don't have to do it in the exact same order I do it. You just have to do it at some point. So we're going to keep this, change this, and flip this to start. And then you're going to have some options. You can see that we have multiple X's places, we have multiple Y's places. If you want, you can start canceling now. If you don't want to cancel, you can try to combine some letters. You could multiply first and cancel later. It's up to you. So I like to cancel as much as possible beforehand. But before I start canceling, if I have negative exponents, I like to make them not negative first. So that's kind of just like a prereq before we do anything. If I have a negative exponent and it's on the bottom, I can take that and move it on the top. When it moves to the top, it would become positive. Okay. And so what we would get now, so we have 7x over 4y cubed times 8y cubed over 21x cubed. Because I put the y squared up there, there was already one, you know, one y up there. So I have 3y's on the top. So I like to just take care of the negative exponents because they can kind of trip you up, them being negative and everything else being positive. I like to do that first. And then I like to start canceling stuff because typically when you start canceling things, numbers get smaller, which makes the question easier. So number-wise, if you look at the numbers, 4 goes into 8 twice. So I can cancel over there, right? And 7 goes into 21 three times. This is going to start getting, it's going to start looking really ugly when you start canceling a lot, so make sure you guys are like watching as I cancel, because it gets really ugly. So now I can also cancel. I have y cubed and y cubed, those cancel completely, right? Y cubed and y cubed cancel completely. The x and the x cubed won't cancel completely, right? They'll only cancel a little bit. So I can cancel one x and one x. So I'd have two x's left. And then what's left, if you can see what's left, there's a 2 up there, and that's it. And on the bottom, there's a 3 and an x squared. If you have a hard time seeing what's left, then you might want to cancel in multiple steps, right? You know what I'm saying? If it gets really jumbled and you can't read it, you might want to just rewrite it and cancel again and rewrite it and cancel again. You can do that as many times as you want.
So if there's something like on the other side in like the denominator, would you cross multiply?
Say that one more time. Give me more.
So like, okay, you see where the 4y cubed did?
Yeah.
Let's say like there was like a 3 there or something. Would you cross multiply?
You can't cross multiply it like this.
Yeah.
Can't cross multiply.
Oh.
That's something that you do across an equal sign. So yeah, cross multiplying is something we do for like equations.
Oh.
to solve for x, and it's just a shorter way of using the multiplication property twice. You don't want to do that here. You just want to multiply, like, the fractions. So if you wanted to, in theory, if you want, you could start the question off with multiplication and multiply stuff, but then, like, you have to multiply 4 and 21, and it's kind of big, and then you have to multiply 7 and 8, and that's 56, and you have two really big numbers, and then you have to figure out how to cancel them after that. That's why I don't do it that way. But you could. Like, there's no right order that you have to do anything in, because you're essentially multiplying and dividing. Like, as long as you're doing it the right way, you can kind of mix and match, like, what order you want to do it in. But I do it in this way because I don't like big numbers. and I think it makes the question a little bit easier. But there's definitely, like, more than one way to get your answer. And then even more still, this denominator can still factor. So I'm going to factor that as well. So that should factor to x plus 1, x minus 1. And then from there, now we can cancel. Now, if you can combine some of these steps, like if you're really good at factoring and you don't need to show this in three steps, don't show it in three steps, it's fine. But you do need to do all of these things. You need to make sure it's factored completely before you cancel. If you don't factor completely before you cancel, your answer won't be completely simplified. You could then try to simplify your answer later. Like, it's never too late. You can always go back and, like, more simplify. It's just easier if you kind of get it all on the table. So, okay, I can cancel x plus 1s and x plus 4s. I can cancel this x right here. Yeah. And I think that's it. Yeah? So on top I have 2x minus 1 and I have x minus 5. On the bottom I have the negative, the x minus 1, and the 3, which is weird. Actually, I should put the 3 in front of here. So I'm going to do negative 3 and then x minus 1. Because if you have a number like a constant, you always want to put that in front of the binomial so that you can distribute it and it doesn't look weird. And then you would FOIL out the top and distribute the bottom, which should give you 2x squared. That's a negative 10 and a negative 1, so negative 11x. And that's going to be a positive 5. And on the bottom, I get negative 3x plus 3. Or you could also do 3 minus 3x if you want to do it that way, too. So that's a long one. And also, like, you don't... If you know a different way to factor that isn't this, then you can do that too. Just as long as you're doing it well and efficiently and getting them right, I don't care. Questions on that one? Yeah. Any other questions?